There's a big new report from the Federation for Immigration Reform, FAIR, it's called, that says illegal immigration is costing American taxpayers $116 billion a year. That's after taking into consideration the taxes illegal immigrants pay back to the government. We should note that FAIR is a nonprofit group that advocates for less immigration into the United States. And joining us now for a reaction is Elvira Salazar, excuse me, I'm a little tongue-tied, a host on Mega TV, and in Chicago, Steve Cortez, a Fox News contributor who served on President Trump's Hispanic Advisory Council during the 2016 campaign. Elvira, I'll start with you about, you think that this study is not correct, it's underrepresenting the amount of work that people who are here illegally are pumping into the economy?
That's correct. And thank you for having me. FAIR, basically what they're saying is that the illegals are taking a lot more than they're giving. And reality is that how could they substantiate that? Because there are no hard facts on people that simply don't exist on the books. But we do know, for instance, that if you are paying $5 to this guy that is picking up oranges in the scorching sun in Florida for 12 hours nonstop, that orange juice that you and I were drinking is a lot cheaper than if we were to be paying $25 an hour to somebody that was born here, because I wouldn't do that job for $5.
Well, that might be true, but Steve, this study, again, like, they've got their numbers, and you know, we have to accept that they have their methodology. Do you think that this helps strengthen the president's case that we have to do something to try to curtail immigration in the future?
Oh, I absolutely do. And I think Elvira, by the way, I think actually makes my case for me. I think she's correct. It's not just the direct costs, and that this FAIR study that you're talking about was the direct costs, law enforcement, education, healthcare, what we spend as taxpayers on illegal immigrants who shouldn't be here in the first place. But it's the indirect costs, what they've done to wages in this country. For instance, wages of legal immigrants. People like my father, Hispanics, what they've done to African Americans. When you have an unfettered flow of low-skilled, illegal immigrant labor into this country, as we've had for decades, I believe it's one of the key reasons that middle-class wages have been so, have languished for so very long. I mean, it just makes economic sense that that's what will happen. So Elvira's right. It might make our orange juice cheaper, but guess what? It's also massively depressing to the wages of legal Americans, whether native-born or immigrant.
But it's also true that they are paying that close to 2 million people in this country are paying federal income tax, and they are paying Social Security taxes. And those monies will never be claimed by anybody because they're illegal.
Well, and however, but it's interesting, Elvira and Steve, I want you to react to this because there's a new Fox News poll that just came out today. And I thought this was kind of shocking. This is the question. What should happen to illegal immigrants working in the United States? If you look just in about a year, it's gone from they should be legalized. You know, that was 74% of the country said legalized at the time. Now it's 83%. Steve, what do you think is going on?
Well, you know, look, we are a country of immigrants, and we love immigration. It has to be done legally. It has to be done by the rules. I'm the son of an immigrant. So is President Trump, by the way. Mm-hmm. But we cannot conflate illegal immigration with legal immigration. There simply is no comparison. And by the way, I think the people who are most, who are, should at least be most offended by illegal immigration are legal immigrants, because it's a difficult process to come to this country. It's expensive. It's time-consuming.
Yeah, but the reality is that illegals are here because there are jobs waiting for them. So if we really do not want illegals, then there's something called E-Verify that no one really talks about. Yeah, but no one talks about it because the agricultural tycoons and the construction magnates do not really want the E-Verify, because then all those people that are working for a lot less than American-born, then it would cost them a lot
more.
Right.
There's also,
their payroll would go up 20%.
There was also this report today, Steve, that the deportations are way down, but arrests are way up. So there's a question, I guess, about what's happening there. Do you know?
No, and listen, I think that this is an important point. President Obama was called by a lot of Hispanic groups the deporter in chief.
Yep.
He deported more people than all other presidents in history combined. Somehow a lot of folks on the left seem to want to overlook that. I don't think President Trump has at all been soft on deportation. For instance, ICE tells us that this year, and we still have 3 months to go in 2017, but this year there have been 2,700 gang members, illegal immigrant gang members, who have been deported versus only 2,000 in all of 2016. So there's some good stats. I love that ICE is. Here's the thing, too. We cited that poll about 83%. Do I want to go after every single illegal alien who is here, and other than their status is being a good person?
You don't
want to
go after the cleaning lady.
Don't.
That's what's happening right now. What's happening is that the arrests are up because the cleaning ladies are being arrested.
Not only the gang members. Cleaning ladies are not being arrested.
Absolutely, they're being dangerous. And I'm not saying that they are not illegal.
They are illegal,
and they should not supposed to. They are not supposed to be here. But I think that we should maybe wait for them for the immigration reform law in order to settle this problem.
Well, what's pretty interesting, as I always say, Trump is the wall, right? Because
80%
attempts to cross are way down.
80%.
You have the deportation issue that is you're getting rid of the criminals. The question about the arrests, that is a big one, but also I think that the administration should look at this number in this new Fox News poll just out tonight, that 83% of those respondents said they think that illegals should have a way to become legal
some
in the
type
country.
Of legality.
I mean, that is pretty remarkable, and so you can't get 83% of people to agree about standing for the national anthem, so maybe we've got a way to get some consensus here. I'm sorry, Elvira, we've got to run.
Yes.
Thank you, Elvira.